Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinski's Tutorials. Today I'm going to do a little walkthrough of the update that Tera Pro Brainz in-app purchase just got. So Tera Pro, by the way, this synth by Versen is just $6 at the moment, and the Brainz in-app purchase is $5. This update is free for people who already have the Brainz in-app purchase. So basically, what this does is it adds 8 modules, and these are the modules that Mutable Instruments added to the Plaits Euro rack that this is based on a few years ago, added these extra 8 oscillator types. So here at the moment we're on this phase distortion one. So we'll take a quick look at these and maybe just review a couple of important things about Tera Pro. So semi-modular synth, it's one of those ones that you definitely, for most people anyway, they're probably going to want to read the manual. So if we look at the Brainz UI here, this is what it looks like in the updated version after you press this little button here. So this is the 16 options that you had in the original version. So things like, for example, look here, dual classic waveforms, granular cloud, and so on, right? So then we tap this and we now get eight different types. So let me just play again here. So here, the first one, classic wave shapes, virtual analog synthesis with filter morph, and then it shows you what different things the harmonics, timbre, morph, and auxiliary will control. Talk a bit more about those in a minute. So let's just quickly look at the 8 types. So this one here, this is these, analog subtractive synthesis wave shapes, triangle, sine, and so on. And you just dial in your timbre here, and then morph between the waveforms with this. You bring it up here, you're also bringing in more of this sub-oscillator. Okay, so exactly like with the Eurorack module, the idea is a lot of sound design potential controlled by just a few knobs. The auxiliary setting. So it's really important to understand a little bit about how Tera Pro works if you want to make sure you're actually taking advantage of that. So if we look at this preset that I'm using here, here for the amp, there are 2 inputs, Brainz and filter 1. Let's change this to Brainz auxiliary. And so now what this blend knob is doing is it's blending between the kind of regular Brainz output for this oscillator and then the auxiliary output. This was a feature that the Eurorack has. So nice that you can blend between them. So let me just skip through these. So phase distortion, 6 operator FM, another different 6 operator FM, and a third flavor. Here, this one's really cool, wave terrain synthesis, string machine, and 4 square voices for chords or arpeggios. So let's just jump back and see now how this blending between the main output and the auxiliary output works. So that's what the auxiliary output sounds like for this one. For this phase distortion, we're hearing the auxiliary. Let me change the blend. Now we're just hearing the main Brainz output. That's the auxiliary again. So here, FM, regular, and auxiliary. FM2, regular, auxiliary. I'm not hearing much there. It's probably something to do with the way the timbre knob's set. This one, I hear a lot of difference. So that's regular. And that's with the auxiliary fully up. String machine. Let me change the harmonics for this. That's the auxiliary. And that's the regular one. So a couple of things about how Tera Pro works, just as a quick review. When you have these boxes here at the bottom of sliders or knobs, these can be used to modulate those. So here you can see that ADSR2 is modulating the timbre knob, and here we're dialing in the depth of that modulation. So if I tap here, I can choose different modulation sources. If I long press on this, then we see ADSR2 and we can change its attack, decay, sustain, release, and so on. So that's an important thing to know. And then to close that again, just tap on this, right? Tap to expand or close something. Here again, tap. Here we just got a very basic Brainz interface where we choose the oscillator types, that's all. Tap, and now we got the full thing. If you want to play with the ADSR of the synth, then you go to the amp section and let's look at the expanded version. So in the expanded version, a little bit harder to find, looking around here, see ADSR1 is modulating volume. So if I again long press on this, now we have this opening up, and here is where we dial in attack. This is one thing I don't like about Tera Pro. Because it's got this scrolling UI, sometimes when I'm trying to adjust a knob, things move and it's unintentional. I think this is very cool, but I really dislike that, and I wonder if there's a way to make it not happen. Does anybody know? Maybe it's just a matter of technique, I don't know, but it often happens to me. There, it happened again. I didn't want to scroll that. Super annoying. And so here, for example, you see that, you know, ADSR attack is being modulated by velocity. Typical synth behavior. But look, I mean, you can set it up that it can be modulated by all kinds of things. So this is very much in the spirit of the modular stuff, you know, because you really can do extremely experimental stuff. Now, another important thing to pay attention to. So this Plaits has this low-pass gate, and you can set the decay and the color of that. Now, the thing is, if you play around with these on the presets, so let me just jump through a few presets, maybe. Okay, let's look at this one here. So if I play with these, let me change that timbre a little bit. Bring the timbre up a bit. Lovely. Really like the sound of this one. Wave terrain synthesis. So, if I play around with these, you're not actually going to hear any difference. Because these control timbre and morph, but only if there's nothing assigned to those. So here I have to tap here and choose no modulation. And now, this low-pass gate can act on those. And again, how much it acts will depend on, you know, what we've dialed in here. Okay, so really nice free update, and can't believe Tera Pro sale price, just $6. It's really a bargain. Oh, another thing I'll just look at, actually, that people might not know how to do if they're not all that familiar with this. Like, if you, let me select the keyboard here. So if you, let's say you're in a totally different preset, like one of the early factory presets, or you're in a preset related to one of the earlier in-app purchases, like, say, the FM7 or whatever. But let's just stick with this one we've got now. How do you actually add the Brainz module? Well, there's a few different things you could do. Go to the amp section and see what's going into the amp section. So here we can see the mixer is being fed into the amp section. So this is actually combining a few things. We've got some Karpeless physical modeling synthesis. We got oscillator 1 and this special oscillator. So we have a few choices now if we want to add Brainz in. Either we could add it into the mixer, right? So in which case we just tap on this empty slot and go to Brainz, and then we would choose Brainz or Brainz auxiliary. Or we tap here and just choose one of these to bring into the amp section. Let's just say Brainz. And then we would use this to blend between the mixer output and Brainz output. So let's have a listen. So here it's just given us the mixer output. This is the way the original factory preset sounds. And now I bring in the blend amount. And now that's this Brainz one. And I'm not really hearing much, so let's change the timbre. Or maybe change the type, right? And so now we can go back here and mix between those. And we can also modulate that blend with the, well, set up now for mod wheel, but we could again set that up to something different. So Tera Pro, really, really powerful. Okay, everyone, hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy.